Get your lip clip on whenever you go in the hallway.
Your teacher tell you to do something, do it.
Go obedient and do what you're supposed to be told.
You need to stand up and do the pledge, because that's being obedient, and it's
respectful.
Mm-hmm. And it's responsible too, isn't it?
And it's responsible.
When you're checking the watchroom.
Quiet when your teacher's talking. Being a pro in the hallway, you gotta keep your lip clip on and put your hand behind your back and be quiet in the hallway. What your teacher tells you, and leave a space in front of you when you line up.
Good morning, ELP. I just wanted to share that I have a book box or a book bucket in the media center, and I wanted to share a couple of books with you guys. One of my favorite books is Diary of a Wimpy Kid, and it comes with many titles and different series. And one of my favorite reasons is it's just always silly and fun to read. And it was one of the first fiction books that my son really enjoyed reading. Another one is any of the Elephant and Piggy books. These are hilarious to me, but they're also great for teaching how to read with expression. And they just have a really unique friendship, and it's a lot of fun to read this one. I also enjoy reading Diary of a Worm. When I taught first grade, about springtime this time of year, I would always bring in worms when we'd have a worm farm. And this is just a really fun way to learn a lot of facts about worms. And it has a nice sense of humor too. Another book that I enjoy is A Bad Case of the Stripes. And what I really like about this is this little girl at first doesn't want to eat lima beans because she gets made fun of at school because people say they're gross. And I think it's interesting that she comes to the place where she doesn't worry so much about what people think of her anymore. And I think that's a great lesson. And then this is a beautiful book, Sulwi. I might be saying that wrong, Sulway. And it's just a beautiful book about really getting to the place where you can appreciate your own uniqueness and your own beauty, even if it doesn't look like everybody else's. And then, of course, this is a great story, and a couple of the classes may already know what I'm about to ask about this story, and that is, this story I want love for you to borrow and read is Alan's Big Scary Teeth. Now, this isn't in the library. This is something that your teacher would have to come and borrow and read to you guys. But it's just a great story. It has a big secret in the middle of the story. So read this and check it out and see what the big secret is all about. Thanks.
Good morning. Wake up to a brand new day.